According to a new report, the so-called Gaetz Eight, the eight Republican lawmakers, Matt Gaetz being their leader, who ousted Kevin McCarthy 4 months ago, are now finally getting their comeuppance. And they're getting it in the form of donors slamming the door and their wallets in their faces. These eight Republican extremist lawmakers are now finding it very difficult to get their donors to return their calls. And of course, the donors have decided, we're not going to give you any more money. Let me read this. This is from CNN. The eight House Republicans who took the unprecedented step of removing Kevin McCarthy from the speakership are facing blowback, both in Washington and back home. It's a sign that even 4 months after the historic move, emotions are still raw inside a GOP conference that is continuing to reel from McCarthy's ouster. Representatives Nancy Mace of South Carolina and Bob Good of Virginia have arguably received the most incoming fire, with both now facing serious primary threats as they gear up for reelection. And Representative Matt Rosendale, who recently jumped into the U.S. Senate race in Montana, is facing headwinds in GOP circles in part because of his vote to boot McCarthy, as top Republicans fear he will cost them a pivotal seat. Rosendale has, by the way, only raised $98,000 because the big donors who loved Kevin McCarthy. Kevin McCarthy, by the way, was a phenomenal fundraiser, which is why he was elevated to the top of the GOP there. They don't want to give to Rosendale. They don't want to give to Bob Good. They don't want to give to Nancy Mace. The only one who's not necessarily in as much of a financial pinch as the others is Matt Gaetz, the leader of the whole operation here. Gaetz, according to this report, he raised $1.8 million last quarter. That's a lot. It's a lot for a guy in a deep red district. So Gaetz is okay, right? Well, not exactly. Because you see, Matt Gaetz has some other problems on the horizon, compounded, of course, by his decision to kick out Kevin McCarthy. See, Gaetz has that House ethics investigation that, as I talked about the other day, they recently got his text messages. They've got multiple cooperating witnesses, including the young woman who he allegedly paid for sexual activity. So that $1.8 million he raised last quarter is probably not going to be used in the general election. Instead, it's probably going to be used in his primary down here in Florida. Now, again, as everybody knows, I live in his district, and every 2 years, he has a host of Republican challengers primarying him for that seat. Typically, he doesn't spend a dime worrying about saving his seat. He knows he is going to win the primary and go on to win the general in this deep red district. If we get a House Ethics Committee report during this primary, because the voting's not till August in the Florida primary for his House seat, so we got a long way to go. And if we get a report saying that he did the things that we all think he did, then that $1.8 million's not going to take him very far in a primary fight. His opponents are going to bloody him up. And if that report comes out, it's going to further hurt him with the fundraising. And again, because of the McCarthy ouster, he's not going to have enough Republican allies in the House to back him up. So Gaetz may be doing okay right now, but as time ticks on, things are going to get much worse for him in so very many ways. But I also want to point out, this just shows the kind of turmoil that is happening within the Republican Party. Okay, it's not bad enough that they have a candidate who has 91 felony convictions. It's not bad enough that all their Biden investigations have fallen apart and they're getting humiliated with that. It's not the fact that they couldn't pick a speaker and then they couldn't pick a speaker again. It's not the fact that they haven't passed any legislation or that they passed the fewest pieces of legislation last year than ever before in history. It's all of it combined. That is what Democrats need to be capitalizing on. The voters see it. The Democrats just have to weaponize that in their ads this year. And this extra little piece of the puzzle here, this is another good piece of fodder for the Democrats to use to take out these Republicans in this election. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.